Welcome to Mark Medley's Everything Disney.
Miss out. Safari guide for the next 2 weeks on our 2 week long safari through the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. I do have a couple of safety reminders before we get out there. I do need everyone to remain fully seated at all times. This is for your safety and the safety of the animals. We want to ensure everyone who starts this 2 week long safari off with us is also going to end this 2 week long safari off with us. So make sure you stay seated. If you have little ones, they are welcome to sit on your lap. Just make sure they stay seated. Don't raise them up in the air like they are baby Simba, and don't pass them around like they are a hot potato. You're also welcome to take as many pictures as you would like. Remember to hang on to all those items pretty tightly. Heading here into the little tree forest, on our right-hand side is our first animal. This is the okapi. It has that brown coloration with those white and black stripes lining its legs. Most people assume that this animal is going to be related to the zebra, but it's actually the closest living relative to the giraffe, which is often why it gets the nickname the forest giraffe. Just in front of that okapi here are some greater kudu. These are female greater kudus. You can tell that because they do not have horns. Male greater kudus will have horns that can extend up to 6 feet off their head, which is depicted on that animal spotting guide in the bottom right and left-hand corner. We're done heading down here onto the Safi River Valley. The Safi River Valley is home to some pretty large animals that like to be fully submerged underwater. That animal is the Nile hippopotamus. Coming up here on the left-hand side, these animals are nocturnal, so they're going to be night active, staying submerged underwater for the majority of the day and coming out at night to graze the grass for their food up to a mile away from their normal habitat. These white birds that are sitting on the island there are called pinked-back pelicans. During the day, those male pinked-back pelicans are going to spend most of their day trying to find a girlfriend. Yes, they are trying to find their mate. What they do is they swim around and find sticks. They try to find the biggest, the tallest, the longest stick that they can find and present it to those lady pelicans out there, hoping that they will become mates. Can I see all five of those baby giraffes coming up here? You can tell that they're baby giraffes because they're standing only about 8 feet tall. Giraffes are born in at 6 feet tall and they can grow up to that 16 feet marker. But those giraffes are born in a standing position and experience a 6 foot drop into the world. That animal animal that just vocalized there is an Ankole cattle, and it is a form of domestic cattle, but it's not used for its meat or its milk. It's used as a status symbol in Africa. So the more Ankole cattle that you own, the wealthier you are considered. Those very large horns that they have there can get up to 10 feet apart from tip to tip. They're made out of a honeycomb-like structure, which their blood will circulate through to keep them cool on those very hot days out in Africa. Coming up here on the right-hand side, there's an African elephant. African elephants are the largest of the elephant species, weighing up to 20,000 pounds. They have some pretty flexible trunks there. Those trunks can have up to 100,000 muscles in them, which is why they're so flexible. Just to the right and left of an elephant's trunk are its tusks. Elephant's tusks are used for lots of different things. They can grow up to 18 inches long. That's how you can distinguish how old an elephant is by how long their tusks are. The longer the tusk, the older the elephant. These trees on the right-hand side that kind of look like they're upside down are called baobab trees. Baobab trees remain leafless for about 9 months out of the year. That's to conserve water. Animals can break the bark off those baobab trees when they are in a drought to receive that water, which is often why the baobab tree will get the nickname the Tree of Life, which is the symbol of Disney's Animal Kingdom. Coming up here on the left-hand side are some flamingos. This is a flamboyance of greater flamingo. If you pay attention to what these flamingos are standing on, their island is the largest hidden Mickey on Walt Disney property. Greater flamingo are the largest size of the flamingo species, weighing in at about 9 pounds. They get their very light coloration from the type of shrimp they eat, those brine shrimp, which is high in beta carotene, turning their light gray coloration that they're born with into a very light pink. Flamingos are not usually a migratory species, however, they will migrate due to issues like water quality and pollution. A way that you can help stop this unnecessary migration is by ensuring all of your plastic ends up into the correct place, into the recycling bin, so it doesn't end up in these animals' habitats. See a white rhinoceros here to the left-hand side. White rhinos weigh in at about 5,000 pounds. They can actually only see about 10 feet in front of them. If you look at their mouths there, they have very wide mouths, which is actually how they got their name, from a mistranslation. The Afrikaans word wyd means wide, referring to those very wide mouths. Wyd got mistranslated into white, which is why they're called the white rhinoceros. White rhinos also like to roll around in mud. That mud adds an extra protective layer to their 3-inch thick skin, helps to keep them cool on those very hot days out in Africa. This rock formation here to the left-hand side is called a Kopi rock formation. Kopi rock formations usually house those larger cats like lions. Lions are nocturnal animals, so they're going to be night active. During the day, those lions will sleep and they'll come out at night to hunt for their prey. Female lionesses are going to do the majority of the hunting for their pride, which is what a group of lions is called, while those male lions are going to stay back and watch over the young and their land. You can see that male lion in the very center of that rock there. You can tell that is a male lion and not a female because it has that very large mane. That mane can weigh up to 50 pounds in itself. Lions also do have some pretty large padded paws, which help them sneak up on their prey. Those lions' coats are the reason why their numbers are declining out in the wild, because they are being sport hunted in Africa as trophies. Something Disney is doing to help stop this is partnering with a bunch of different organizations in Africa, forming the Protect the Pride. The Protect the Pride's goal is to help double that lion population out there from 20,000 to 40,000 by 2015. Coming up here on the left is a scimitar-horned oryx as we enter the last part of our Harambe Wildlife Reserve, the Magadi Glen, home to some very thick and rich vegetation and some blooming flowers I see here. A scimitar horned oryx is a pretty impressive animal. That's because it can withstand temperatures of up to 115 degrees outside before it starts to sweat, but it can also store water in its body for up to 9 months. All the animals out here on this reserve are here for a reason. They are either close to endangerment, endangered, or close to extinction. Reserves all around the world that we wander on right now use lots of different conservation efforts to help all those animals out. Some things you can do here in Disney's Animal Kingdom is simply taking pictures of all the animals that you see and sharing them on social media. Because here in Harambe, we believe that what you see in your eyes is truly what you feel in your hearts. So share those pictures with your friends, your family, and your neighbors so that they can see what you saw with your eyes and also feel it in their hearts, coming together to make a change for all those animals out there who can't make a change for themselves. We also do have the Disney Conservation Fund here at Animal Kingdom. Disney will match every single dollar that you donate to it. You can do that at any merchandise stand throughout the park. Now it does look like our 2 week long safari is coming to an end with the help of some Disney magic and some animals, of course. Probably only about like 21 minutes and 22 seconds. Heading over to Rilla Falls Exploration Trail and the Maharaji Jungle Trek to see some more animals today. The Maharaji Jungle Trek is located in Asia. The Gorilla Falls Exploration Trail is just to the right of the safari exit. There are two baby animals on those trails. On the Gorilla Falls Exploration Trail, there's a baby gorilla. Her name is Grace. She's about 8 months old. She's absolutely adorable, likes to hang out with her mom by the glass. So we recommend heading over there. But also, if you want to take the train to Conservation Station at Rafiki's Planet Watch, you can go over there to the Affection section and see a baby goat.
We proudly present the Festival of the Lion King.
Greetings, everyone. A hearty welcome. We have been expecting you. We are here today to welcome you, one and all, to the Festival of the Lion King.
Noises. One, two, three.
Come on. I've been wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata! Ain't no passing craze! Hey, Popo, what are you doing over there?
I'm in the warthog section! Besides, my little legs can't make it down off this float!
Oh, gee, that's too bad. Guess I gotta do a sit-load. Hakuna Matata! What are you primates doing? Put me down. Bad monkeys! Bad monkeys! Well, this stinks.
Sorry.
No, not you, Pumba. These monkeys, they're ruining my big number.
But they're so cute.
Cute? Look at them. They're picking bugs off each other.
Or dirt.
Come on, everybody. You know the words. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze. It ain't no worries for the rest of your days. It's a problem free philosophy. Hakuna Matata. That's a motto.
What's a motto?
I don't know. What's a motto with you?
There they go again.
Gentlemen, direct from a record-breaking 2 million years at the bottom of the evolutionary ladder, let's hear it for the Tumble Monkey!
Thank you. cat. Let's take it home.
Not for me. gather together at the water's edge as one community in celebration of life. Like generations before us, we share stories of youth, discovery, danger, and love. Stories reflecting the emotional journeys of animals and humans alike. For we are of one heart, sharing the same air, the same water, the same earth. These stories remind us of the powerful bond between all living things, illuminating our understanding of the world around us, and forever uniting us in the great circle of life. beyond this place, beyond tonight. It flows within our hearts, within our souls. As you journey forth, remember the connection we share with our animal friends. Tell their stories and carry the wonder of nature with you. For we are one with all living things in the great circle of life.
This has been a Rockinium production.